Welcome to Analytics with Nags. In this video, we're going to see our setup SQL Server Analysis Service and what are the softwares required in order to build the analyst service model. Let us see in this video. If you're new to this channel, hit the subscribe button right now to learn the concepts in SSAS. So we know this model, BI architecture. So now what are the different things? So let me explain it from this perspective. And let us go here and come again there. So what softwares to be there? If you already have some SQL Server DBMS, that is database engine that you use to store tables, then no need to install SQL Server again. Whatever it can be, 2012-14 version is fine. You need to have that. Then you need to install SQL Server Analysis Service that we will see it now. So, and SQL Server DATATOOLS, this tool is used to create this cube, okay, our SSAS Tabular model. That is why this tool needs to be installed. And once it is deployed and we need to process the Tabular model manually, sometimes we require management schedule. So these are the softwares you need to be in handy before working without any issues. And management studio is also optional, but still you need to browse and check it whether it's deployed properly or not. For that it is required. Let us see all these four softwares. Let us try to compare it in the architecture. Now first thing is like DBMS. So where it will get the data, usually it's from the database or data warehouse. So that is why you need to have a SQL Server DBMS on your system. Then in order to build this Tabular model, how you will build using this DATATOOLS. DATATOOLS is a software that will contain BI related tools. Like you can create ETL tools, you can create SSAS cubes, and you can create SSRS reports as well. So DATATOOLS is a combination of three modules, not only three, it has other, but predominantly we use DATATOOLS for these three purpose. So using DATATOOLS and using analysis service, you will create the Tabular model. For that you need this DATATOOLS. And analysis service, as I said, using a software you will install it. And management studio is a client tool that use it to connect to database or Tabular model. You can browse it. Those things we will see it once we install it. So with this note, let us jump into a demo. So all these things can be installed and using this single link. And one more thing I want to highlight is like you may require some prerequisite .NET framework in your system. If you already have, that is fine. And if you are installing for your organization, you need to check with your DBAs or administrator who manages the systems. Okay, let us try to launch it. So basically I'm using only the evolution version. So just use this SQL Server link or any other link if you want. So start your evaluation as a exe or Azure. Click on exe that you are going to download it locally and install it, and that will hold good for 180 days. This is only for those who are learning this technologies. For actual scenarios in your organization, you can go for enterprise or developer based on the licensing capabilities. For this is for those who are practicing on their own. So go for evolution and just click continue. Provide the descriptive names. I hope your Gmail also is fine. Just click on OK. then it will prompt you for some details. Let us go for it. Last name, I will say analytics with Nags, and then click on continue. So once you are done, you can able to download. So it's already happened. Once it is done, it is downloaded now. Once it is downloaded, just click on it, and it will ask for some options like how you do it, like whether you want Microsoft or SQL Server to install the default options, or you want to choose custom. So choose appropriate options, and based on that different things will come. So basically select basic installation type that will install the database engine with default configuration. So I would recommend go for custom. You can choose what you want, just follow my instruction, and this will what it will do is, after extracting all the software, it will put it in this folder, local folder. Then you can again double click on the exe file and install it. So that is where the folder is asking. Choose some folder and click on install. Okay, so let us go for SQL and SQL 2019 and install. It will download all the setup files, and we will wait for the download to complete. Once you have done with that custom option, then once it is downloaded, it will prompt you for this option, and it is like planning what your system configuration you want to check, what are the things you need to do. That just it's a planning, and you need to click on installation. So whatever we saw in the presentation over here, like these tools, DBMS, Analysis Data Tools, Management Studio, you can download it from here. Okay, I mean everywhere. So basically this will lead you to the link. So first we will start with installing your database engine and analysis service. With these two things we will start. For that you need to go here, that is new SQL Server standalone. Go to this. So just check if there is any update, that's fine. Click on next. Then it's checking for any updates after we download, because we will keep it in our local and we will not do it. So I don't want product update. I just downloaded, that's fine. So install setup files. Now it is checking whether it's fine or not, and it's setting some firewall rules. It is my local system, so there is some issue with the firewall, that's okay. Then I already installed this and I have a name like Naga MSBI tab, so that is fine. This is for demonstration I'm doing. So perform new installation of SQL Server, just click on it. You can have multiple instances, and if you have a license you can put it. This is evolution which will expire in 180 days, just keep it as next. The one most important aspect of is clicking licensing terms is fine. The important aspect where you will choose these options, right? What I'm doing, so I need to choose only this and this. Okay, SQL Server comes with all the features. You see here database engine, and you have analysis service, you have a data client, integration service, what you want to install. Okay, that is why we choose custom. Otherwise if you choose default at the beginning, then that will install what are the basic options required for installing a database engine. It will install. So choose this one, database engine services as well as analysis service. So this two will install you the this option will install database engine, this option will install you the analysis service. Okay, next window we will see what mode you want. So as you have, our analysis service comes with a multi-dimensional tabular, so you will choose in next screen. Just click on next now for now. So future rules, it will prompt you and give the name for the instance, just as you like. I will say test for now. I'm not going to install it, as you want to install it. I already installed it. I'm just going to cancel it. Okay, so after choosing that, you give account name. If you are administrator, you are not part of the administration, that is fine. Those who are in admin, they can able to configure these accounts. They have some service account, using that they will configure it. Now some other configurations like database engine configuration, who is admin for this, whether he is required mixed mode, you have some set some SSA password or Windows authentication. I will go for default option, current, add current user as my admin. Then this is what I want to highlight. So here you choose, see the options. This playlist is all about tabular model. Please choose this one so that it will be sync. So if you choose some other option, even if you are installing some other versions, if the option is chosen as multi-dimensional, switch to tabular. Okay, tabular mode, then use current mode. So that will install your analysis services as a server, okay, in your system. So this is the option. Then finally you click on next. It will see all the rules, whatever it is installed, it will check everything, then click on install. It will take some time, and once it is done, we will be back. So I'm not going to do it, as I already installed it. So once it is installed, let me tell you what happens. So quick, and it installed in a few minutes. So now we have successfully installed analysis service tabular model, and it doesn't contain SQL Server database engine. Okay, and let us try to launch this analysis service, and we can proceed further how to create tabular cubes. Okay, we have seen we have already installed database engine and analysis service engine, and the screen you have seen before, it contains only analysis service because database engine I already installed, as I mentioned before. So let us try to install these two. So what you need to do, so the folder you have given, okay, that contains these packages, that extraction package, just click on once again. Okay, that will prompt you the same options. The first two softwares we installed using this option. Now you are going to install the data tools. Okay, that is used to create the cubes. Okay, for that, click on this. Again, it will prompt you to this link. Okay, then you can install it using Visual Studio Installer, it is saying. Either you can go for it or you can download it from here. I already have a Visual Studio 2017, just install it from here. Okay, so you can click on this particular standalone installer, then it will follow the instruction. It's just it will require some double click. Okay, this is step number two. Once you install, it will appear like this, Visual Studio 2017 SSDT. Okay, once you launch it, it will appear like that. So I'm not doing it because it is already part of it. So the steps are very much clear. Go to this link, from navigate from here, data tools, and do it. The second link. The one last thing is SQL Server Management Studio. That also available in this link. Just click on it. It will again prompt you to download the latest SQL Server Management Studio. This I will do it because I hope I do not have latest one, and it is little more. It requires 635 MB. Let us wait for some more time. Once it is installed or downloaded, let me install it. Okay, the SQL Server Management Studio is downloaded. Let us try to install it. Double click it. That will prompt some window, and that will walk us through installation steps. Click on S. Yes, what it is asking. It's saying Microsoft SQL Server Management Studio with Azure Data Studio as well. So this is the latest file I'm installing. So it will install everything. Let us go for it. It's always good, right? I mean, anyway, in future, everything is in Azure. So obviously, it is good to install the latest softwares, whichever is required. I think it will take a couple of minutes. Let's come back once it is done. Okay, I think the Microsoft Management Studio is installed and it requires a restart. So basically, now we have installed DBMS, Analysis Service, DATATOOLS, and Management Studio. And DATATOOLS, I didn't show a demo. These two, as well as Management Studio, are shown in this demo. As I already installed certain tools, so I'm skipped it. So in your case, you do the appropriate installation. Now, after restart, let us try to launch all these tools, whether it's working fine or not, in our next video.